and out the corner of my eye, I saw a pretty little thing approaching me. She said, I never seen a man who looks so all alone. Could you use a little company? If you pay the right price, your evening will be nice and you can go and send me on my way.
Hey guys, it's Liv, and today we're in Charleston, South Carolina, which, as you guys know, The Outer Banks is filmed here, and The Outer Banks is like my favorite show ever. So we're gonna take a little trip around the Charleston area to some of the most popular filming locations, and we're gonna bring you guys along. So let's go.
Guys, we're together.
My mom wanted to show you her amazing map skills. Look, we like mapped out everything.
But you gotta glue it together. Wait.
Ooh.
And that's so
all the locations
amazing.
We can like see how far they are, kind of like to get a general idea.
So we're not driving all over.
So thank you, Mom.
Yeah,
it's great. We're at Starbucks right now getting some food right before, because I think one of the drives is like 30 minutes away, so we haven't eaten anything.
So the first location we are arriving at is the motel that they were at in season one, where JJ and John B were using the key that they found from the boat under the water to get into. And they found like the gun and everything. It has the famous housekeeping knock that JJ does. Their room is right there that they were in. Here's the room. They have so many cameras. Jeez. This is the marsh he and Pope were sitting in. JJ and John B were standing like outside of the window hiding. We tried to get in because we saw something on TikTok where it's like decorated on the inside, like Outer Banks, but they said that someone was staying there, and I was like, oh no, I was knocking on the door saying, housekeeping! No! So, but this place is actually really cute. So now we're walking to the location of where Topper and Rafe go to chase down Sarah and John B at the observation tower. And then Topper ends up pushing John B off of it, and then he gets his broken arm. So it's like a little walk, it's like a forest type thing. We don't know how long we'll be walking for though, so it's kind of scary. We're at the top now. It's so pretty. We're on Pitt Street right now, which a lot of the scenes were filmed on, and there's actually the police station right there. But like this whole street they used for filming it, it's just so cute. Now we're on to see the restaurants. So Key's dad's, or Key's family's restaurant, The Wreck, and then Hayward Seafood, which is Hope's dad's restaurant, like right next to each other. The Wreck is an actual restaurant, like you can eat there and stuff, and it's supposed to be like actually really good. Oh, look what it has, hold on. It says Outer Banks. So we are at the Cameron's house right now, and right behind me is actually the dock that Ward died on. It's just so crazy to think that they were all running across that, and his boat was like over there somewhere.
That part was so cool. The house looked so gorgeous, and there was a wedding going on, and there was like a lot of stuff set up, and a huge bus full of like 50 people left like during it.
Hey guys, okay, it's day two of going to see locations because we didn't want to do it all in one day. So now our first location of the day is the Limbrees house, which is the Edmonston Alston house. We toured it like 5 years ago actually, and it was so cool. So it was crazy to see it in the show, but we're gonna go walk by it now. They were like running through all through the back and stuff, but we're not gonna go all the way back there because there's like people eating.
Okay, so now we are at the Gaillard Center, I think that's how you say it, which is like the library thing that John B. and Sarah went to looking for the archives for like maps for where the gold is. After they get off the ferry and go get dressed at Ben Silver, this is where they come.
It's where the famous Vlad and Val scene was in here. I think you can go in it too, but I'm not sure. Okay, so unfortunately it's closed. It literally closed at 2 and it's 2:02, so wow. But I was trying to see if I could like see into it. One of the steps, and they were like right at the top, kind of like around there before they went looking for the archives.
Now we're at Miss Crane's house. So in season 1, all the Pogues were trying to find the gold, and the gold was like buried in her like basement thingy. And she was a scary, creepy old lady that started shooting at all of them.
Okay, so I'm gonna get out and go look. Okay. Here's the house. I think they used like that, like they kept that little thing, and then like there was one up there and then one on the other side to make it look like a big tower. But crazy. So all the Pogues were like running through there and hiding, trying not to set off the lights for the outside so they could go in there and like find the gold. That's so cool. See like how much editing they did? Like this is what I was talking about. It looks like a whole nother like, it's a like it's gonna be a huge mansion, but it really just looks like that. Like that is so crazy how they do that. Oh my god.
I'm editing this right now and realizing that the amount of times I say like in this video is actually not even funny, so I'm really sorry for that. I promise I'll try to get better. I just get super excited about things and don't even realize what I'm saying because I'm super just excited. So I'm really sorry. Just please bear with me. I know it's bad.
Okay guys, so that was it for looking at some of the most popular filming locations from The Outer Banks season 1 and season 2. There were so many other places and locations we could have went that were just way too far away but also played like a huge role in the show, but maybe one day we'll see those, or I'm sure next season when they come out there's gonna be tons of new locations and we can try to see those. It was so cool seeing how different everything looks like in the show and then what really happens behind the scenes of like CGI and editing it and just like angles of certain things. So this was really fun. Comment down below if you liked this, give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and yeah, thank you guys for watching. Mwah!